I want us to realize some changes need to take place.
我只是要告诉大家，是要做一些改变。
How do we maintain unity?
我们如何保持合一？
While we release,
但我们同时能够释放。
The next generation of kingdom builders.
下一个世代的国度建造者。
That was the title I was given for this talk.
这是我主题的信息的主题。
Right, it's about releasing this next generation.
就是要释放我们下一个世代。
But the problem with Chinese.
但是华人的问题就是。
We are not good at releasing.
我们不很容易放手。
We like control.
我们喜欢抓在手里。
We want to control our children till they're 70 years old.
我们想要控制我们的孩子直到他们70岁。
You know that.
你知道的嘛。
Your parents were the same way.
你们的父母亲也是一样。
They want to control everything.
他们要控制所有的事情。
Where you go, where you work.
你去哪里，你在哪里工作。
Where you live.
你住哪里。
I'm a grandfather.
我是一个外公。
And my mom still wants to tell me how to be a dad.
但我的妈妈还告诉我要怎么样做爸爸。
It's just this, and yet here's our title is how do we release them?
我们今天讲的主题是怎么样释放他们。
There's got to be a way where we've got to let go.
我们需要放手。
To release them.
释放他们。
And yet stay as a fellowship.
但同时也保持这样的交接。
To not get frustrated when they want to do some things differently.
不要心中感觉挫败，只因为他们要做事，用不一样的方式做事。
But to look at the scriptures.
而是再回到神的话语里面。
And say, is it actually more biblical?
看说他们的方法是否是更加合乎圣经道理的。
Because if it's more biblical, then maybe we need to change.
如果他们的方法是更合乎圣经，也许是我们需要改变。
Or just to say, is this best for the kingdom?
或者从另外一个角度看说，这样做是否对整个国度是更好的？
Because I believe it's best for the kingdom to release them.
因为以国度的角度来讲，我们需要释放他们。
My kids understand the younger generation better than I do.
我的孩子了解这个世代比我更加了解。
I spoke at their public school last week.
我在他们的公立学校啊。有一个演讲。
I was amazed at the response.
我实在对那他们的回应感到非常的惊奇。
I was amazed at how much the world had changed.
我惊奇这个世界有这么大的改变。
And yet they understand that world.
但他们却很明白他们所处的那个世界。
And so I entrust that mission field to my children.
所以呢，我把那个世代的合唱就交给了我的。
It's not my job to reach the middle school and high school students.
我没有办法去接触到那些初中生、高中生。
That's their job.
那是他们的工作。
And I need to release them.
我需要释放我的儿女去做这样的工作。
The Bible says that the Holy Spirit is in them if they believe.
圣经说圣灵在他们的里面，如果他们信的话。
Do you understand what an amazing thing that is?
你明白这是多么奇妙？
That the Spirit of Almighty God lives inside of them?
全能神的圣灵住在他们的里面。
That's a powerful thought.
那是多么强大的。
Let me ask you, when does the Holy Spirit of God enter them?
我想请问大家，神圣灵是什么时候进入到他们里面的？
At what age?
在哪个年纪？
7, 8, 9, 10?
七岁、八岁、九岁还是十岁？
I mean, isn't it whenever they believe?
不是当他们信的时候，圣灵就进去了吗？
So when they believe, do they receive the Holy Spirit?
所以当他们信主的时候，他们有没有得到圣灵？
Do they receive the entire Holy Spirit or like a Holy Spirit Junior?
他们是得到全部的圣灵，还是一个小小的圣灵？
And if they have the entire Holy Spirit inside of them,
如果他们已经得着全部的圣灵在他们的里面。
Then what are they capable of doing?
那他们能够做些什么？
See, a lot of times we put the kids aside.
很多时候我们把孩子推到一边。
We're like the disciples that say, no, keep the kids away from Jesus.
我们好像那时候的门徒说啊，把那些孩子带开，不要在耶稣旁边争闹。
Let's put them in another room.
我们把他们放在另外一个房间。
While we do the important adult things.
当我们做这些更重要的事情。
And Jesus said, no, let the children come to me.
但耶稣却说，让这些孩子来到我这里。
And he tells them, unless you change and become like little children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven.
而且耶稣告诉门徒说，除非你们转换成小孩子的样子，你们无法进入神的国。
That's a strong statement.
那是一个非常强烈的话语。
See, I discovered something as a dad.
当我做父亲之后，我发现了一件事情。
I was so obsessed with making my kids grow up and become like me.
我实在都致力在让我的孩子长大，而且长得像我一样。
And some of that is good, some of that is right. We're supposed to teach them.
当然，这里面部分是好的，是对的。
But the Bible also teaches that I have to learn from them.
但圣经同时告诉我们说，我需要向他们来学习。
The younger people have a faith that I don't have.
这些年轻的孩子有这样的信心是我所没有的。
When you teach them about miracles, they actually believe it.
当你教导他们奇迹、神迹的时候，他们马上就相信了。
It's easier for me to teach a 10-year-old about the power of the Holy Spirit than it is for me to teach you.
当我对我来讲，教一个十岁的孩子有关于神迹、有关于圣灵的大能的时候呢，比我教各位来的简单。
Because there's something that can die out as we get older.
因为某些东西，当我们在成长的时候，它就慢慢的消失了。
And that's our faith.
那就是我们的信心。
You know, when you've had a lifetime of failure.
当你经历一辈子的这种失败。
It's hard to maintain faith.
很难还保持着信心。
When you have a lifetime where things didn't work out like you thought they should.
当你一生所经历的都觉得好像不如预期。
It's hard to have faith.
很难继续保有信心。
But for the kids, they get to start off clean.
但对孩子来讲，他们是从一个空白的白纸上开始。
And that's why Jesus said, "Let the children come to me."
这就是为什么耶稣说让这些孩子来到我面前。
And he says, "Unless you change and become like those children, you won't enter the kingdom of heaven."
若不回转像小孩一样，你无法进入天国。
And the thing that Jesus mentioned was their faith and their humility.
耶稣讲到这些孩子们的信心以及他们的谦卑。
We need to learn from that.
我们向这些孩子学。
Pretty soon, I stopped praying that my children would have my faith.
很快的，我就不再祷告说我这些孩子有像我一样的信心。
And I began to pray, God, let me have my child's faith.
我开始祷告说，神啊，让我有像我孩子一样的信心。
In our churches, when someone is sick,
在我们的教会，当有人生病的时候，
we ask the children to pray for them.
我们请这些我们的孩子们为他们祷告。
We can't afford to have them in the other room.
我们不能够让他们就在另外一个房间。
I need to have their faith in my room.
我需要他们的这样的信心在我的房间。
Because they believe more than I do.
因为他比我更相信。
If I had cancer right now,
如果假使说我现在得了癌症，
I would gather the children to me.
我会聚集这些孩子。
I would talk to the children in the church.
我会告诉我教会里的孩子们。
And ask them to pray to God that I would be healed.
请他们为我祷告，神来医治我。
Because they could believe that it would happen.
因为他们真的相信神能做到。
I wouldn't ask the 50 or 60-year-olds.
我不会请五六十岁的弟兄姐妹。
I seriously would not ask the people of my generation.
我不会请我这个世代的人来为我祷告。
I mean, I would tell them and say, "Yeah, pray."
我会告诉他们说，呀，我现在有这个状况，你们为我代祷。
But it's so hard to convince a 50 or 60-year-old that miracles can still happen.
但是很难去说服一个五六十岁的人说，神迹到今日仍然会发生。
But I know I could convince the 10-year-olds.
但我相信我可以说服一个十岁的孩子。
See, we need to be committed to one another.
我们需要对彼此有那样的委身。
We need to see the strengths of one another.
我们能够看到彼此里面的那个优点，那个力量。
And for the younger people,
对这些年轻的一辈。
Actually, I'm not one of the younger people anymore.
我已经不是那年轻的一辈了。
I'm a grandfather.
我已经是外公级了。
But I need to set an example of respecting those who are older than I am.
但是我需要有一个好的身教，如何来尊荣那长辈。
But as a grandfather, I also need to set an example of releasing the younger generation.
但同时做一个外公，我也要有一个好的榜样，是如何来释放我们年轻的下一代。
And not quenching the fire.
而不是消灭他们里面的那个热情。
And always telling them that they don't know enough.
然后告诉他们你们什么都不懂。
And for me to control everything because that's most comfortable to me.
让我掌握一切事情，因为那对我来讲是最舒适的。
But trust the power of the Holy Spirit in them.
但完全信任在他们里面的那个圣灵。
And devote myself to the fellowship.
并且我委身在与他们的交通当中。
I am so excited about the future of the church.
我对教会的未来带着极大的兴奋。
I believe it's going to look different.
我相信未来会看起来不一样。
But I also believe that that difference is going to be good.
我也相信这个不一样是会更好。
If we stay devoted to the right things.
如果我们对对的事情坚持。
And we're also willing to repent of the wrong things.
而对之前的错误，我们愿意来悔改。
How to keep changing.
如何继续的来改变？
And yet make sure some things never change.
但同时也确定某些事情是永远不变。
That's going to be the challenge as we move forward.
这就是我们继续往前的挑战。
Releasing.
释放。
And yet begging the next generation to devote themselves to the right things.
但是带领我们的下一代能够对对的事情上面能够坚持。
See, I have a dream.
我有一个梦想。
I dream of churches all across America.
我梦想在全美的各个教会。
Where people gather not to hear a speaker.
人们聚集不是要听某一个有名讲员的讲道。
But they just love the reading of the Word of God.
而是他们单单渴慕神自己的话。
I have, yeah. I really believe it's possible.
我真的相信这是可能的。
Where people become devoted to prayer.
人们会对这个祷告有委身。
See, right now, people will gather if a great speaker and a great band are going to be in the room.
现在很多人会聚集，因为某一个有名的讲员或者是好的音乐敬拜。
But I actually dream of a day when people will gather just to pray.
但我是在梦想有一天人们聚集只单单为了祷告。
There's a pastor, Jim Cimbala.
有一位牧师 Jim Cimbala.
He said years ago, you can tell how popular a pastor is by how many people come to the Sunday service.
他说你可以来评估一个牧师到底多受欢迎，在他星期天来参加主日崇拜的会众人数。
And he says, and you can tell how popular Jesus is by how many people come to the prayer meeting.
但是你可以评估到底耶稣有多受欢迎，就是在来参加祷告会的人数。
I believe there's going to come a day when people will actually enjoy prayer.
我相信有一天人们会享受祷告。
I love prayer meetings more than I love hearing people preach.
我爱祷告会超远远超过我听别人讲道。
Just that chance of experiencing the power of God.
就是那个机会来经历神大能的作为。
I love it.
我爱。
I dream of a day when people will love communion. It says the early church they used to go from house to house just to break bread.
在初代教会，他们可能一家一家的这样子互相擘饼。
Because they would just stare at the mystery of the body and blood of Jesus.
因为他们就会在这神的身体跟宝血的奥秘当中不断的思想。
I believe that day is going to come.
我相信有一天这个事会发生。
Again, here in the U.S.
在美国本土。
When people are devoted to the apostles' teaching, to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer.
当人恒心遵守使徒的教导以及祷告交通。还有薄饼。
See, that was the beautiful thing about the church in China.
在中国的教会就是有这么好美好的见证。
The underground church.
地下的教会。
They didn't have amazing speakers.
他们没有有名的讲员。
They couldn't.
他们没有办法。
They didn't have amazing worship bands.
他们也没有很好的敬拜团。
They had to devote themselves to the right thing.
他们把自己委身在对的事情上面。
And God grew that church.
而神就让他们的教会增长。
To millions and millions of people.
上百万的信徒。
And I believe if we devote ourselves to those same things,
我相信如果我们也在同样的事情上委身,
it can happen right here in America.
在美国一样能够发生。
And I want to be a part of that.
我希望我是在那当中的一份子。
That's why I'm so excited about the church.
这也是为什么我对教会的未来感到无比的兴奋。
I don't know how much longer I have on the earth.
我不知道我在世上还有多少的时间。
My parents were never this age.
我自己的父母从来没有活到像我现在这个年纪。
So I don't assume that I'm going to live much longer.
所以我不能说我还可以活多久。
But I tell God I want to live a little bit longer.
但我跟神说，请再多给我一些生命的时间。
Because I want to see that dream actually happen here.
因为我希望看到我的梦想成真。
Where the church loves the word of God again.
教会再次热爱神自己的话语。
They love praying together.
热爱一起祷告。
And they love communion. I want to be a part of it.
我要在那当中。
And I hope that you do too.
我也希望你也成为那当中的一份子。
Thank you.
谢谢。